Our family has had farmland in Watonwan County since 1878, and there's been some form of a farmer in the family since then. This particular property we've owned since the 1930s, and you know, many years back, my dad was out here with my mother and grandfather planting plums and other native wildlife plants. And so that's kind of part of the interest here too, is to be able to maintain those plum and hawthorn forests that have kind of come up for the wildlife benefits, but knock back the buckthorn that has been a problem both competing with those native plants we've got in here, but also our soybean crop. Today out here looking for the buckthorn in the forest and trying to identify them so we can control them now. These are the overwintering host for the soybean aphid, which ends up being a significant crop pest in southern Minnesota and throughout the state, and also not only a crop pest, but a significant expense to a farming operation when they get to a level where you have to control them. So if we can knock them back by controlling their overwintering host, that's my goal here. This time of year, we're in early November, post-harvest, so getting a chance to get out and do some of these other projects. And as you can see, the buckthorn are still holding on to their leaves, so it's a really nice time to be able to differentiate between the buckthorn and some of the native hawthorns and plums that would have already lost their leaves at this point. In the wintertime, the deer and pheasants especially really like this kind of brushy winter cover, but we want it to not be buckthorn in the future. It gets intimidating looking at this, and it's a lot easier to come out here on a day like this and pull some than you know, some of your other techniques, because if you just cut it, it's just going to come right back again. So, and you kill them if you can get them pulled up, and it's particularly easy on these small ones. They just have a fibrous root system. They reproduce from seed, so it's you know, as long as you get this root up, they should be dead. Here's another buckthorn right along the side of the field here, and you can see the berries. So this berry producing plant is going to be a high priority one to control, because this is the source of other infestations other places. So this would be a first one we'd want to come back to. On this map, I've been marking these large berry producing ones with an X, and just areas that have buckthorn in general, kind of circling those or highlighting those. But these ones with an X are a particular focus. And one thing we can do too is, you know, pull out our phone and take a photo of the location and the individual tree, so that we know when we come back here in January or some other time that we have more time available, and they're easier to see now though is when we want to mark them. But in January we can come back here and cut that tree and get a some kind of stump treatment on it as well to keep it from resprouting. Well, the major challenges on this particular property are hot spots of buckthorn. And so we're relatively fortunate here that the buckthorn is somewhat isolated on this farm to particular areas, but in those particular areas, it's really dense. And so my first approach, which I've started on a different part of the farm, is to go through and get those seed producing trees first. And then the next phase is going through and getting the younger, thicker, brushier buckthorns. And so a challenge is it's pretty easy to go just with a chainsaw and cut that first several large ones. It's that follow-up that can be an ongoing challenge.
Obviously, we're spending a lot of money to control aphids. So if I could, you know, even if it cost me what it cost me for a year of spraying aphids, I would be more than happy to try to get rid of buckthorn if that would be success and get rid of the aphids. I worked pretty hard to try to get it out of this area. I can't speak for all farmers, but I would say the mass majority of us feel the same way. If we could, if there was some effective and efficient way to control buckthorn, we would do it. So I was down in this area about 5 years ago with the rough cut mower and then used a little Tordon, and I'm not seeing any buckthorn. So that's good. This is a big one. Yeah, we'll have to come cut this down and clean the chainsaw out here. As farmers, we really consider ourselves environmentalists. So I wouldn't say I take offense, but when people say, well, environmentalist group want to work with farmers, I am a little offended by that, because we are environmentalists. And so I just say, let's work together. You know, we're all environmentalists, aren't we?